Aerial Knights Never Yield is a game I honestly have difficulty truly vocalizing my thoughts on because there's just not much to it. The title is an auto-runner, a genre already infamous for repetitive gameplay loops. Ultimately, not much else is done throughout this game to really make it stand out beyond the pack. Aerial Knights Never Yield has players take control of Wally, who, according to the product's store page, is a mysterious character who has recovered what was taken from him. I bring up the store page because the title itself lacks dialogue, so I didn't know what was going on, and the brief cutscenes do an inadequate job of portraying the narrative. The lack of clearly told story is not necessarily a fault though, despite there being no initial hook, and is far from the more pressing dilemmas. This is an auto-runner, which I'm sure for many raises a considerable amount of red flags. Auto-runners are infamously known for their frequency on the mobile gaming market, and they are admittedly quite popular due to their quick-to-parse gameplay philosophy. This title is on consoles though, and the shallowness of the gameplay loop is not revamped or qualitative enough for its placement on the platforms. There are four actions players can perform throughout the stages, which correlates to the four face buttons or the D-pad if preferred. Additionally, these very same actions are denoted by specific colorations. You can slide by pressing B or down. When objects appear in blue glow, short hops, as I call them, are performed by pressing Y or left, with the objects coded yellow. Standard jumps are done by pressing X or up on the D-pad, and must be used when the objects are painted in red. And lastly, a dash can be used, which is not denoted by the specific color, and must be used to outspeed select foes. That is basically all of what the experience is. Every stage follows the rules of these actions, with nothing else occurring. To say that I grew bored swiftly would be an understatement. What made this process initially more dull was how normal mode, the default difficulty, slows the running speed down whenever approaching a selection of the stage requiring an action. So, for instance, if there was a truck that must be jumped over, the stage slows down when approaching this object, giving needlessly ample time to utilize this move. I found this to ultimately ruin whatever challenge or excitement the gameplay could provide, especially given the checkpoints littered around the stages. There is essentially a lack of tension or necessity to coerce the player to play better aside from scores and unlockable outfits. Thankfully, there are two higher difficulties, hard and insane, with the latter finally removing the slowdown present before approaching obstacles. I believe this should have been the default mode after running a tutorial of demonstrating the action, since I really don't see what joy could be derived from being handheld through each obstacle via a slowdown. Even when playing on insane though, the experience ends up being a standard mobile auto-runner, and any uniqueness the game instills only makes itself known through the soundtrack. The music of this game is one aspect that gripped me the most, as it's a series of bops to say the least. From the dramatic ambiance of the title screen to the adventurous whimsy of stages, every track is by far the highlight of this otherwise stale experience. If you play this title for any reason, the soundtrack will assuredly be what stays in your mind the most. One irritating trait that stuck out to me throughout the stages was when playing with slowdown enabled, there was a lack of optimized collision at objects. For example, when approaching an object I have to slide under, there is too much time given to the player to act when the slowdown is present, to the point that you can wait until the very last second and input the move, which results in an almost beta state looking series of frames that will have Wally running through whatever he should not be able to. This baffled me because prevailing over these hazards is one sense of reward players can feel. Having it look as half-assed and unsatisfyingly haphazard as that made progression an even blander chore. Visually, the title is passable and seems to be going for this minimalistic art direction, with there being a somewhat distinct vibrancy spread throughout the terrain and models, though the cutscenes are somewhat rough around the edges. While the scenes are all brief, they are almost humorous thanks to the awkward movements and occasional frame dips. Whatever narrative was being told throughout this game was lost amid its lack of optimized and stilted performances. Aerial Knights Never Yield doesn't do anything to stand out as an auto-runner, an already congested genre. While the soundtrack is incredible and the visuals are stylish, the gameplay lacks any sense of fun, creating an almost mindless experience through its 2-hour runtime. The game's features almost hinder the experience, removing the challenge of tension from the stages. Unless you're aiming to dominate the leaderboard, this is one auto-runner that is all eye candy and no substance. Noisy Pixel is giving Aerial Knights Never Yield a 5 out of 10. Thank you for watching. Please read the full review at noisypixel.net. Noisy Pixel is run by a group of gamers who work hard to deliver news, reviews, previews, and more. Please subscribe to keep up with all our future content.
Noisy Pixel.